Hello everyone, welcome back. In the previous video, we discussed the efficiency classes of an algorithm. In today's video, we are going to discuss about one of the important topic in case of algorithms by name asymptotic notation. Let's start the discussion with what do you mean by asymptotic notation and what is the reason for using the asymptotic notation. If you see here, I have used asymptotic notation. Asymptotic notation can be used to compare and rank the order of growth of a function. We use the asymptotic notation. Here, as I told, to compare and rank the order of growth of a function, here the function is nothing but, or I can say this function expresses the time complexity of an algorithm. So this is the main objective of using asymptotic notation. To compare and to rank the order of growth of a function, we use asymptotic notation. There are five different types of asymptotic notation, namely, first one is big O, which is denoted with this particular symbol. Second one is big omega, denoted with this symbol. Third one is theta, denoted with this particular symbol. Fourth one, small o, and finally small omega. Small o is denoted with character small o, and small omega is denoted with this particular symbol. So note that these are the five different types of asymptotic notation that we use in order to compare the time complexity of an algorithm. This five asymptotic notation can be compared to five numerical operators. Like I can say big O is nothing but less than or equal to, big omega is equal to greater than or equal to, theta is nothing but equal to, small o is just less than. Please note that, okay, the difference between small o and big O. Big O is used to indicate less than or equal to, but whereas small o is just less than. So you can make out small omega is nothing but greater than. Please make sure that you remember these five things. Big O is nothing but less than or equal to, big omega is nothing but greater than or equal to, theta is nothing but equals, small o is nothing but lesser than symbol, and small omega is nothing but greater than symbol. Don't worry, we'll see what do you mean by big O, big omega and theta, as well as the small o and small omega asymptotic notation. Now to understand what do you mean by big O or big omega or theta or small o and small omega notation, let's take two different function. Let me take T of n and g of n be two non-negative function. Let's assume that T of n and g of n be two non-negative functions on a set of natural numbers. Wherein T of n is the time complexity, or rather than writing the time complexity, let me write T of n is the actual time taken by an algorithm and G of n be the function. Here also T of n is nothing but a function which denotes, T of n is a function which denotes the actual time taken by a function, and g of n is a function, or I can say g of n is a sample function. Sample function used in order to compare the value with T of n. So with these two things, we can define all these notation. Let's start with the first asymptotic notation by name big O. coming to the definition of big O notation, if you see, a big O notation can be defined as a function t of n is said to be big O of g of n, denoted by t of n is equal to big O of g of n if t of n is bounded above some constant multiples of gn for all larger values of n, if there exists some positive constant c and a positive integer n0 satisfying the statement such that t of n is less than or equal to c into g of n for all value of n greater than or equal to n0. Note that c in this case should be equal to 0 and n0 should be greater than or equal to 1. In the sense, let me take one example. If this is my, this is a graph wherein x-axis denotes the input size n and y-axis denotes how exactly the function grows. Now the definition of big O says that t of n should be less than or equal to c into g of n. Let me have a function. This is my c into g of n and this is my t of n. Now and this point is n naught. Now don't worry about what exactly is the relationship between t of n and g of n before this n naught. After this n naught, t of n should always be less than or equal to c into g of n. This is what this diagram represents. Or I can say that big O notation, in big O notation, t of n grows with same rate. It grows with the same rate or it grows with the same rate or with t of n grows with the same rate or lesser with g of n. This is about the definition of big O notation. This is the most classic definition that you find in almost all the textbooks that are related to algorithms. Now coming to an example, let me take an example. Let me have t of n as 3n plus 2 and let me have g of n as n. Now what the definition says? The definition says that in order to have t of n is equal to big O of g of n, this is nothing but t of n is less than or equal to c into g of n. Now my objective here is, let me substitute the value of t of n and g of n. T of n is 3n plus 2 less than or equal to c into g of n is n. Now I need to find for what value of c naught and for what, not c naught, for what value of c and for what value of n naught this equation is true. Now let's find the value of c. Now if you see, it is 3n plus 2 less than or equal to c into n. Now if I substitute c value as 1, now what happens is 3n plus 2 is less than 1n, so obviously it is false, so this can't be my value of c. Now c is equal to 2, 3n plus 2 less than 2cn, this is also false. If I take c value as 3, 3n plus 2 less than or equal to 3n, less than or equal to 3n. Even in this case, 3n plus something is there, even in this case also it is false. Now let me take c value as 4. Now let's check 3n plus 2 less than or equal to 4 into n. Hope, okay, this should be fine. 3n plus n, even if this part is also n, it becomes 4n. 4n is less than or equal to 4n. Or I can say it is 3n plus something is less than or equal to 4n. So it implies that c value here is 4. Now coming to value of n0. what should be the value of n naught? Now let's try to substitute the value of let's try to substitute some value for n, and let's see for what value of n this holds good. Now if I take a value of n is equal to 1, so this becomes 3 into 1 plus 5. So 3 into 1 is 3, 3 plus 2 is 5, 5 less than or equal to 4 into 1. So for n is equal to 1, this becomes how much? 3 plus 2 is 5 less than or equal to 4. Is this true? This is false. So this can't be the value of n. Now let me take the value of n is equal to 2. So n value as 2, it becomes 3 into 2 is 6, 6 plus 2 is 8. 6 plus 2 is 8. 8 less than or equal to 4 into 2. 4 into 2 is 8. If you see 8 less than or equal to 8, this sounds good. This is fine. Now if I take n is equal to 3, so this becomes 3 into 3 is 9. 9 plus 2 is 11. 11 less than or equal to 4 into 3. 4 into 3 is 12. Even this is fine. Even if I take n value as 4, even for that also the condition will be true. But the nearest one is n equals 2. So what is the value of n naught? Here n naught value is 2. So I can write 3n plus 2. I can write 3n plus 2 is equal to big O of n. This should be fine. Now if you see, both this function are of a linear thing. In the sense, in my previous class, I wrote the efficiency classes, wherein efficiency class was, let me take here. Efficiency class, initially it was constant, that is, I am writing the constant with respect to 1, constant less than log n, log n less than n, n less than root n. In my previous class I have not introduced root n, I will introduce root n here. Next, it is less than, sorry, this is one less than log n, less than root n, less than n, less than n log n, less than n square, less than n cube, less than n to the power of 4, 2 power n, less than 3 power n, less than n factorial. Now, if you see, here I have taken both this t of n as well as g of n as a linear function. That is, this was my t of n and this was my g of n. So, this was my n. Now, in this particular case, this is fine. Now, can I write it as n square is equal to big O of n cube, big O of n cube. Is this fine? Note that n square is less than or equal to n cube. At most, this can be equal to n cube. In this case, it is less. So, I can write, I can use big O notation in between these two functions. N square is equal to big O of n cube. Can I write this as n square is equal to big O of n square? Please check. Even this is also fine because both are equal. Can I write n cube is equal to big O of n factorial? Can I write n cube is equal to big O of n factorial? So comparison is n cube. N cube is here and to my right hand side there is n factorial. Even this is fine. Now can I write n square is equal to big O of log n? Check. It is n square. Now to the right hand side I should have efficiency class. But here, I have an efficiency class to be compared on the left hand side, not on the right hand side. So, this statement is false. This is about what do you mean by big O notation. Hope this is clear. Thank you.